Hi friends, here we are going to write very simple Python script, and that is simply printing some message. So here I am going to print hello world using your Python script. And whatever the script you are going to write, that I am going to write using VIM and default IDLE. So here we are going to see a simple Python script by using either VIM editor or default IDLE, right? Let me open first of all my command line on my Windows operating system. You can write same program, same script on your Linux or any Unix like systems as well, right? So guys, I'm moving into my desktop. There I'm going to create Python scripts directory. Let me enter into that. See, as of now, you don't have anything in this directory, right? See, if you want to use VIM editor, first of all, you should have VIM on your host. So in our previous video, we have seen different types of editors, and I have given a link to install VIM editor on your Windows operating system. Anyway, by default, VI is there on your Unix-like systems. You can use VI on your Unix-like systems. But in Windows, you don't have VI, but you can install VIM, right? So I already installed that. Now let me run VIM simply. Hello world.py. You can take any name, guys, any script name you can take, and extension is .py, just to know that that is a Python script or Python program. Now let me enter VIM space some program name .py. Right, now I am going to open your VIM editor. I opened that, right? See guys, my intention is I have to write some Python script or Python program. And if I run that program, I have to get output as simply some hello world, right? So to print something, to print some text or message or string in your Python, you have to use print simply parenthesis in double quotation. You have to write your text or message or string, whatever you want to print through your Python program. That's it. So print parenthesis, then inside parenthesis with quotations, you have to write some string or message or text, right? Now let me save this. First observe your script, whatever you have. So this is our script, right? So this is like in Windows cat command, right? I am seeing my file, my program, my script. Yes, this is the line in my program, okay? So now I am going to run it, Python. So guys, if you want to run your script, Python script, you have to run in this way on your Windows operating systems. Python space your program name. But before going to that, check it whether you configure your Python on your host or not. Yes, I am getting some version means I have a Python on my host and that version is some 3.7.0. Now I can use Python space hello world .py. See the output, you're getting hello world, right? See guys, here you have to understand one more thing. While running, you are running in this way, Python space your hello world .py, some program name .py. Now as of now, I am using Python 3, right? So if I want to run same program with Python 3, so already I have somewhere in my host Python 2 as well, right? Let me run with Python 2. So you have to provide complete path because you can't add two paths to your system paths. That's why I'm selecting Python 3 as the default one. And for Python 2, whenever if I want to run my Python script with Python 2, I will provide the complete path for my Python 2 version. So my Python 2 is there in this location. If you want to check, you can check version, right? Now, if you want to run your script using Python 2, just provide complete path where you install your Python, then your program name or script name. See that? That's it. Okay. And guys, whatever we return, right? That script we are running from command line. So this is the first thing you have to know, because as an automation engineer, you have to run your scripts from command line. We already discussed this point. Fine. So guys, if you want to write one more line, so I want to print output like hello world, or welcome to Python. So this is in one line. I want to print one more line. Then print in quotations, whatever you want to print, you just write that information here. So I am writing welcome to Python scripting. If you want to write one more line, let's say print, this is my first script. So now through our Python script, we are printing three lines of information with the help of this script. Let me save it and observe the output. First observe your script. Now run it. Enter. See the output. Whatever you have inside of your print, inside of your quotations, that information is printing. And guys, whenever if you run your Python program, it will run from top to bottom, line by line, right? Very first line, hello world. First, this information will be print, then this one, then this one, right? So this is a simple script with your Python. And here we written our script with the help of VIM, and we are running that with Python 3 as well as Python 2 also, right? So guys, if you are having confusion like running simply by Python or by providing complete Python path, right? Just try to install only one Python on your host and set the path for your Python and just try to work with that only, right? In case if you have both the Python versions on your host, just to provide your, just add your Python path to your system path for only any one of the Python version. It may be 2 or 3, right? And come to command line and just type in this way. Suppose here if you are getting 3.7.0, then by default you are running your Python programs with the help of Python 3 version. So if you want to run this program with any other version, just try to provide complete path of your Python interpreter. That is nothing but python.exe. Of course, no need to provide .exe. By default, it will take .exe extension because you are on your Windows operating system. That's it. Okay. And here guys, I need to provide one more clarity. Observe that in your script, right? This entire thing is a string or text or message. Right, actually this is a string. If you want to print any string on your command line while running your program, always you have to take a print. See here, this is a number, right? Number is also a string if you provide inside of your quotation. String is nothing but group of characters. If you write anything inside of quotations, that will be a string. That is always a string. If you write anything inside of quotations, that is always a string. So print is used to simply to print some string on your command line, on your terminal, on your display while running your program, while running your script, right? Fine. So till now we worked with VIM editor from command line. We know once if you install your Python, right, by default, you will get IDLE. Let me click this IDLE, right? Let me open that IDLE. It's opening. Yeah, it's done. Right. Now you can go with the file and new. Now whatever the program you have, whatever the script you have, just copy and paste it, or you can type it and save it. Okay, you can save it anywhere, right? Otherwise, go with the file and open your existing Python program. So already we have on our desktop. Somewhere here we have some hello world. Now this is the program, right? Now let me close this. Now this is your script. So you can run this from here also. See the output you're going to get. So guys, you can also write your Python scripts or programs by using IDLE also. So for that, what you have to do, just go to your start and then click on IDLE. It will open this IDLE, right? Python shell, click on file, new, in case if you want to write a new Python program, or if you have some existing Python, just click on open and select your Python program from your particular location, then It will open like this. Then go and run here using run module, or from your keyboard you can also click on F5 so that your program will run. Right? So guys, my suggestion is just try to know about IDLE, but don't use this IDLE. If you want to use, you can use it, but my preference is command line vim editor or vi editor on your Unix like systems. Vi or vim, that's it, you can take anything. Okay, so guys, this is the simple way to write simply hello world or any to print some message with the help of your Python. Okay, guys, thank you for watching this video.